Yeah, like this, right? So now she's like hiding her back, which I don't like. I don't want her back. I just want to hug her. Doesn't want me to hug her. It's hurting my feelings, right? But if I keep trying to do the back take here like you were, she's going to keep turning and she's going to get on top and end up in my guard or even maybe pass me. Which is not going to be. Especially Nogi, we don't have grips. So we're going to have to do something about the top. Start going, but she drops to her knee and turns towards me, right? I'm gonna keep my hooks. I'm not gonna let go of my hooks. I'm gonna keep my hooks, right? But now, instead of like trying to turn around to the back, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sit up, I'm gonna make a crunch, and I'm gonna hug her hips, really tight. It's called body lock, right? In Nogi, personally, I feel like the body lock is one of the best grips you can get. Especially if you're taking back. I have a lot of control. Right? So I'm going to be here. I'm making a cable grip with my hands. Right? With my thumbs. With my fingers. Cable grip. And I pull super tight. And I think about taking my gear. Just like making it super tight here. You can make it good if that helps you. Okay? Just hug them like you've never hugged them before. Okay? Right? Now from here, I have two options. I think she just stays here. I can use this body lock to move my hips out and still take them. Okay. Or I like to do from here is I like to walk back onto my back. But since I'm hugging her super tight, she's gonna have to come with me, right? So here, walk back like this. Kick my legs. The leg that's kind of on her front is gonna stay as I kick, but my the other leg, the leg that's behind, is gonna come out. So kick
and come out. See how I'm in a nice leg drag position if you guys know the leg drag. So I still have a staple, but I still have my foot on one side and my knee on the other side. Right? But I also have this really strong body lock here, okay? From here, it's very easy for me now to just start working my way up. I keep my ear super tight. I draw a line with my ear on the back. I can either stop in side control, or I can get my seatbelt and take the back. Okay?
Awesome.
Next guard, I start passing, she defends, right? No good for me. From here, as soon as I can, I sit up and I'm gonna hug her really tight, right? Once I get here, I'm not super fast, I'm not super explosive, so I like to get to positions where I can kind of take my time. I feel like once I get this tight body lock position, she can move, she can do things, and I can just stick to her like glue and follow her, okay? So I'm here. I'm gonna rock back. I'm gonna take my left foot, right? I'm gonna kick her with both feet, but then I'm gonna take my back leg out. Kick. Notice how my hook stays super strong. Right, I can take one out, this one stays here. So when I come on top, I have a really good position, and she can't dig out my leg and leg lock. Okay, that's take my shin, take her in the back, roll her over, put my hands up. Or even a stop. I'll show it one more time, but any questions? Yes.
When you pull your X guard, what if you put the wrong foot? I can't remember which foot you put on the top, so you still complete the move if you put the wrong foot.
Yeah.
You can? Okay.
Yeah, for
so
sure.
You
can finish this move no matter which leg is on top. Sometimes.
Okay.
Personally, sometimes when I do this, I like to switch. My legs, when I'm behind, I like to switch and put this one at the bottom. But if you don't, it's not going to work either. Here. What matters is that I take out the right one. But if I And even if I leave both in,
wait, come here, this is awkward, so I have to take the bottom one out.
Okay.
And now I'm gonna put my toes on the mat, and this is gonna help me get out. Let's do it. Ready? One, two, three.